Hello everyone, in this video we're going to talk about 5 things you may have missed while adventuring through Liyue. For those who don't know where that is, Liyue is the second area where we get to explore and one of the 7 regions that can be found in the vast world of Genshin Impact. So without further delay, let's begin. Thing you may have missed in Liyue number 1, the old couple who isn't actually a couple. On the road to Liyue Harbor near a statue of the 7, there are 2 old people which live on either both sides of the road, an old lady and an old man. If you talk to the old man first, named Uncle Liu, he'll tell you a story about when he was young and how he would always look at his next door neighbor. You know the old lady on the other side? So anyway, Uncle Liu starts describing her and I assume that he had feelings for the old woman. And so when you ask him if he made some moves to the old lady, he starts to get embarrassed and mad, explaining that he should not tell her the way he felt about her. He even tells you where is your sense of shame. So now, if you go talk to the old lady named Shuchi, again I'm sorry if I mispronounce, she tells you that she's just running her shop just to wait for the Uncle Leah to talk to her. She even says that she already reached retirement age and even hits a shot at Uncle Leah for keeping her waiting. Anyway, it is a sad but kind of frustrating story because the fact that they are the only ones living in the area. Uncle Leah still wouldn't talk to the old woman and time has greatly passed that she is still waiting for something to happen. And that is all. Alright, thing you may have missed number 2, the story of the Feiyun Slope contamination. It all starts when you go to the southern waypoint in Liyue Harbor. As you head for the docks, you end up meeting a Millilith guard named Hongyi. When you speak to him, you can ask why he is sad. Then he will tell you about the issue with the contamination of the water supply at Feiyun Slope. For those who don't know where that is, it is where Zhongli's dead body was located during, you know, the Rite of Ascension. The Millilith guard then tells you that people are now having a hard time getting water and some businessmen are turning the situation into a money-making opportunity. He then tells you that he's just a low-ranking soldier and what he can do is to file reports and mentions that Keqing is actually the one in charge. In order to know the full story, however, we have to go to the Feiyun Slope bulletin board found near the giant stairs of Liyue Harbor. From there, we can read up to 16 sorts of info, but for the contamination story, it is mentioned that the cause of the water pollution was a young female taking her own life at the water source. Her dead body had decayed, causing the water supply to get dirty. If you continue to read the bulletin board, it is said that Huachu died for unknown reasons and the property will be sold to cover the expense of her funeral. For those who aren't familiar with Huachu, she is the lady that can be found near the stone gate. You know, the one who is drinking tea with the man? It turns out, she faked her death in order to escape from her father because she wanted to marry someone who was poor. I'm guessing it was the man who she is currently with, but that's just my assumption. The worst part is, the young female taking her own life that was mentioned earlier was murdered and thought to be Huachu. Now if you speak to her, she then tells you that she is the daughter of the manager of the Minghua company. So in a way, she isn't afraid to disclose her identity. She then tells you that she's on an excursion and doesn't tell you where they are headed. Anyway, I think that this is messed up considering the fact that you would let another person get murdered just so you could escape your family or maybe something else. Perhaps if you guys know more about this story, don't hesitate and let us know down in the comments below. Okay, so that was it for number 2. Moving on to the thing you may have missed in Liyue number 3, the story of the missing Yaksha. If you guys watch the story teaser called Yaksha's the Guardian Adepti, it is mentioned that Zhongli, the god of Liyue, summoned 5 Yakshas that would protect Liyue Harbor from demons roaming the place. Unfortunately, as time went on, 3 of them died and 1 went missing. This missing Yaksha is actually called Basashis. It is guessed that he or she is a Jiu Yaksha and that he or she committed suicide. As to know the reason why, we must first head north of Jiu and Karst, here in the map. And we can find a stone pillar or tablet that says that Basashis described the Yakshas as having great might but having no rest from their duties or responsibilities. So, When Li Wei was finally in peace, only the two of them, Aulatus or more known as Shao, survived. From there, it is explained that he got tired of all his duties and wanted to get away from this world, which would conclude that he committed suicide to end his agony. I guess we can say that he is dead? Which means that Shao is the only remaining Yaksha alive. But there are some who speculate that this man located here at Wangshu Inn is the missing Yaksha. Maybe it is because how he says that he stopped using his real name a long time ago, and that he's just waiting around for his life to come to an end? We may not know, really, because of the fact that this is in Wangshu Inn, which is owned by none other than Shao. If he really was Bisacious, then Shao would have noticed. In the end, it is safe to say that Bisacious was the missing Yaksha. If you guys have more details on this, please share it down in the comments below. Anyway, that was all I have for number 3. Let's get on to the thing you may have missed number 4. This one is actually a small one, a detail actually that most people don't notice. When your characters absorb energy particles or orbs, they actually go straight into your character's vision. So, for example, Xingyan's vision is located at the back. I think it's located on her drum. For those who use Xingyan can relate to having been annoyed by the drum sound she makes when sprinting or jumping. So anyway, when Xingyan absorbs the energy particles, it goes straight to her back. It's not much, but I thought I could include it on the list. I hope you don't mind. So now moving on to thing you may have missed number 5. You can actually see Inazuma from Beidou's ship. Well, actually not just Beidou's ship, but from there, you can actually see it up close. As you can see, it's just this not well rendered piece of land that can be found east of Liyue. Some people say that to get to Inazuma, we will have to sail there using Beidou's ship. Yes, it is known that Inazuma is on lockdown. However, Beidou's fleet just returned from Inazuma, and Beidou's fleet is known to be an armed merchant fleet. So as one of the foremost trading fleets, it makes sense that Beidou would be one of the very few people with access to Inazuma, considering that Inazuma would need goods and materials, which merchant fleets bring. So, as new updates drop, we may actually get to see Beidou playing a huge role in future quests. And there we have it. Those are some of the 5 things I had in mind. Now, I'll quickly give you a couple more bonus ones, which probably everyone knows or has heard of. But just in case, for bonus number 1, the Minilith guard found in the Golden House will actually tell you that he's getting worried now that Mora production has stopped. He tells you that the sound of Mora being made is actually satisfying to him. As for the reason why, Mora production stopped now that Zhang Li or Morax no longer have his noses due to having him willingly handed out to the Fatui Harbinger La Signora. For the second bonus thing is that you can actually find 2 stray dogs and 1 cat south of Jiyun Karst, near an abandoned old home. I still haven't figured out the story behind this, or as to what happened to their owners. They will actually follow you if you don't attack them. However, if you get too far from the abandoned home area, they will head back to their original places. And so we're done. Those were the 5 things I think some of you may have missed in Li Wei. Please let me know if whether you were aware of any or all of them, and of course, post your own discoveries in Li Wei that I did not mention in this video. Finally, if you found it enjoyable, consider giving the video a like and perhaps enabling notifications for our channel. Thank you very much for watching, and until the next one, be safe and stay tuned.